Hey, I'm Ford Springer with the Daily Caller. This is Leah Jessen of the Daily Caller News Foundation. We're out here at Marine Corps Base Quantico at the Martial Arts Center of Excellence with Joe Sheshko. And he's going to take us inside and show us what they do here.
My name is Joe Sheshko. I'm the director of the Marine Corps Martial Arts Program. I'm a retired lieutenant colonel, and I've been in the Marine Corps since 1975, so I've got the best job around because I get to get beat up every day, and I get paid to get beat up.
Okay, so welcome to Raider Hall. So why is the Marine Corps Martial Arts Program in this building called Raider Hall? In 2002, we were trying to figure out what we were going to call the building that was going to house the Marine Corps Martial Arts Program. And so three names came out. It was going to be either Cold Steel Walker Room Building, it was going to be the Veterans Building, or the Raiders. And so the Commandant said, I like the Raiders because they truly were the first martial artists in the Marine Corps, in my personal opinion, because of Colonel Cold Steel Walker.
Colonel Cold Steel Walker in 1941 and 1942 was a knife fighting champion in the Marine Corps. He was a Raider, hence why this is Raider Hall. And his job was to train four battalions of Marines in hand-to-hand combat. But they only existed for about a year and a half, and then they were rolled back into the Marine Corps at the end of the war. And we really didn't have a martial arts program until about 1999.
And so in 2003, when we opened this building, we made it Raider Hall in regards to the history, dedication, legacy of our brothers in arms called the Raiders. And since then, they keep giving us all of their stuff. Okay, so most people think this is a museum. It's not really a museum. It's just a place where the Raiders keep giving us their stuff. Currently, there's about 100 Raiders still alive. I think the youngest one is Harold Berg. He's 92 years old. The oldest is 104, Mr. Roberts. He turned 104 in January. Every year, they come back here for a reunion. Matter of fact, they're coming back this Friday, the 4th of May, at 1400, to basically visit their Mecca, if you want to call it. And they also come back in July. And again, there's only about 100 of them still alive, but they still come back and they tell us their stories. Wow. And so all these things that you're gonna see here in the building were pretty much given to the Marine Corps by Raider family. So these weapons, you know, I love telling the story that they came to my house in the post office, and that's probably not the right way to deliver them, but they got there, and we put them up here in display because that's what they carried during World War II. This is, for lack of a special word or anything, this is their Vietnam Wall, if you call it. And so what's neat about this is every Raider that there ever was is up on this bulkhead right here. And so what's really nice about this is when Raiders do come in here and they basically look up their name, and they can see that they served with the 1st Battalion at headquarters in Alpha Company. But what's more impressive is if they were looking at their name and then maybe they saw somebody who didn't make it. Mm-hmm. And so this is their memorial to every Raider that ever was.
Wow.
And so that's why when people ask how many Raiders there were, yes, there were four battalions of 900, that's 3,600 Raiders. But in front of our building to the left, there's 998 bricks in the ground that basically account for every Raider who didn't come home. Okay, so when you lose that many in combat, they're replacements. And if that's the death, you can imagine how many wounded Marines. So there were thousands of Marines that were wounded, and they were replaced also. And that's why there's more than 3,600 names.
Wow.
On this bulkhead. But every Raider that ever was is on this bulkhead. And so I constantly get calls, and somebody says, could you run back here and see if Palmer was a Raider? And I just come back and said, yep, he was a second Raider with Fox Company.
Wow.
Okay, so that's their legacy. How did the Raiders come about? These two gentlemen right here were China Marines, meaning that they were in China before the United States got involved as advisors. And basically, they were trained by Special Operations, the Royal Marines, and so they had a lot going for them. This gentleman here, Carlson, he had an executive officer named Jimmy Roosevelt. And so Carlson wanted to start a special operations in the Marine Corps. And so he went to the Commandant of the Marine Corps and pretty much proposed that we start a special operations capable organization. And the Commandant said, we do not need elite within the elite. And so you would have thought that that individual as a lieutenant colonel would have taken that and saluted smartly, but what he did, in my personal opinion, is he got Jimmy Roosevelt, who just happened to be the son of the president, and they convinced the father to have a meeting, and he pretty much briefed the president that it would be a good idea if we have a special operations capable organization. And so I don't know how the exact verbiage went, but the commandant was told that we will have a special operations, hence the Raiders came to birth. The Raiders were the first martial artists in the Marine Corps. The Raiders were the first special operations for our country. The Raiders were the first to use camouflage uniforms. So if you look at that uniform right there, it was a sateen, and they just took spray paint and sprayed a pattern. And then while they were active duty, obviously, they came up with the first camouflage uniform, and that's what's represented by that that guy right there. It's green on the outside, tan inside, but you can see it's faded quite a bit because of the years. They actually use that other uniform right there. It almost looks like the old Texaco gas station attendant. And it used to be black, but it's just faded after all these years. And so they were the first to use camouflage uniforms. They were the first to use dogs in combat. There's actually a young lady who's writing a history of dogs in combat. And so we put that up there as a representation of that. They were the first to use the Navajo Indians, the code talkers. And there's a code talker radio right there underneath that flag, which was impressive. The gentleman up there on the bulkhead, that's Father Redmond. Father Redmond lived well into his 90s. He was the priest for the battalions of Raiders. And he used that flag, which is a one of a kind, to bury the majority of the Raiders who didn't come home. Not just the Raiders, but our other brothers in arms with the Navy and the Army, et cetera. So it's a one of a kind. And that's pretty much the quick history of the Raiders.
Wow.
Very